and our name comes from Dog Branch Road in Brasstown, because we used to practice on Dog Branch Road.
Practice?
We never practiced.
Wait a second.
Well,
didn't you used to live out there somewhere?
As a matter of fact, I
did.
Oh,
that must
be the idea. We used to play out there, but we never practiced.
So, Martha and David, would you like to sing a song for us?
We'd like to sing it in the worst way. Just give us a chance. Texas Gals. It was first recorded in the 1920s by the group that gave the name to hillbilly music. They were called the Hillbillies. Well.
And I was lucky enough to meet one of them. His name was Tony Alderman. Actually, his real name was Elvis Alderman. And when I met him,
the things you learn from Bob. You just sit still and you learn all these things from Bob. Yes, his name was Elvis.
Well, Tony was living in Washington D.C. when I met him, and had not played the fiddle very much for many years, but he was a fantastic musical saw player.
Huh? Wow.
So anyway, this is.
recorded by the Hillbillies called Texas Gals.
The Hillbillies, by the way, they are, as far as I know, the only old-time band recorded in the 20s that had a piano and a ukulele.
Yeah.
That's rock and roll.
That's Hillbillies.
What I like.
And they actually toured on the vaudeville circuit. They were very popular. Okay, Texas Gals.
Carry these little finger picks around because you never know when somebody will have a really nice guitar that they need to have to play a little bit. I'm bad. I'm known to be bad about not having anything to play on. I always left finger picks and flat picks and rosin, harmonicas, small
that was messy.
Mandolin, you know. Few things up here on the stage in case anybody needs it.
Never. You never left donuts. When did you leave donuts? Never. You wouldn't do such
did
a thing.
Did I say donuts? I wouldn't leave a donut behind.
That's right. That's a new song title.
It's Carter Family tune. We like it. It's the only one we know that has trout in it. So that's a good enough reason I think. Oh, give to me a winding stream, it must not be too wide. With flowing leaves of maple green, near touching from either side. The water must be deep enough to float a small canoe. trout beneath the bank does leave his hiding place. The kingfisher on the bough above, so eager to give chase. Spreading branches overhead, some might even through, and looking near at you. Do not disturb my waking dream. In other news,
getting a little too quiet in here. We better get the accordion out.
Yeah. The old stomach Steinway here. Belly Baldwin.
The Belly Baldwin.
It's great to be here and on this stage in the community room. That was almost a year ago. We played a dance right here.
March the 10th.
Yes, we did.
Boy,
March the 10th. We killed the folks who slapped dead.
We did it.
We were the ones.
That out.
we're supposed to mention we did have masks on.
And I was just kidding about we killed the folks.
No, we didn't.
Doing great. And not only that, but if you would like to, tell them about it, Martha.
If you look at the chats for this, whatever we're doing, Morningsong, I was going to say this adventure, and you'd like to help sustain us until we can come back live, we would sure appreciate it. The link will be there, and we're glad you came to see us today. We're glad to see each other today. My goodness, we hadn't seen each other for a really long time. But yes, the last time we played here was a very happy night. It was the March the 10th, and you were saying, sorry about that.
Right. Well, anyway, I've got my accordion. I'm going to sing a little song here about a bricklayer named Patty, who had an unfortunate experience, and he's writing a letter to his boss to explain why he's not going to be at work. It goes something like this. Dear sir, I write this letter to inform you of my plight. And at the time of writing, I am not a pretty sight. Me body is all black and blue, me face a deathly gray. I write this note to say why Patty's not at work today. While working on the 14th floor, some bricks I had to clear. And to throw them off and off the top seemed quite a good idea. But the foreman wasn't very pleased. He was an awful sod. He said I'd have to cart them down the ladder in me high. Well, clearing all those bricks by hand, it seemed so very slow. So I hoisted up a barrel and secured the rope below. But in my haste to do the job, I was too blind to see that a barrel full of building bricks is heavier than me. So when I had untied the rope, the barrel fell like lead. And clinging tightly to the rope, I started up instead. I shot up like a rocket, but to my dismay, I found that halfway up, I met the bloody barrel coming down. Well, the barrel broke my shoulder as unto the ground it sped. And when I reached the top, I banged the pulley with me head. I held on tight, though no one shot from this almighty blow. And the barrel spilled out half its bricks, 14 floors below. Now, when those building bricks fell from the barrel to the floor, I then outweighed the barrel, so I started down once more. I held on tightly to the
bricks that were scattered all around. As I lay there upon the deck, I thought I'd passed the worst. But when the barrel reached the top, that's when the bottom burst. A shower of bricks rained down on me. I knew I had no hope. And in all of the confusion, I let go the bloody rope. Well, the barrel being heavier, it started down once more and landed right on top of me as I lay on the floor. It broke three ribs in my left arm, and I can only say that I hope you'll understand why Patty's not at work today.
Bravely done.
Yes, bravely done. Well, I can just see everybody in their homes, you know, they don't get like talking, they say to their wife, they say to their husband, they say to their kid, they say to their dog, it all means stop. Stop.
And then, of course, if you did want to stop because you're just starting to learn a tune, then you can do the veto.
Yes, the veto.
And that means you got to play another time.
Are you going to tell the story?
No, I got the story got X'd out. Are you from Dixie? I don't know how long when we started, so I don't know what our time is, or 10 minutes. Okay.
We're good.
Yep.
Hey there, stranger. Smiling face seems to say to me, you're from my homeland.
last sleep. Key of G.
Nathan Hickory.
One of the things that has happened with all the mask wearing that we have been doing is that we have not been singing. So, like I was starting to say earlier, we don't have our mask on right now, but singing is like the hardest thing to accomplish anymore, especially together. So, I highly recommend that you sing in the shower and sing in the kitchen and sing out in the yard until you can sing with your friends again, because what I will testify to is we can't remember the words exactly or how or what key. So keep singing till we get back here.
Well, it cuts that lip reading out, you know, and that's...
Oh, lip reading is super difficult with a mask on.
For cutting tin.
Yeah.
Here we go.
should have done a perfectly good half an hour with us.